Look, we finally got some rain last night. Holy cow, finally. Couple of puddles and stuff here and there. Wow, finally a little bit of rain.
Now the grass will grow.
Anywho, how's she going today, Tubes? Go away, you freaking bugs. Oh man, you walk through that bush there from the house down to here and you just get swarmed by these freaking deer fly. Oh, they're freaking annoying too. Because they're like around your head and they usually land on the back of your freaking neck. And then when they come down and nail you, holy crap, it hurts. Gets you really good. Look at this guy here, eh? Some sort of weirdy kind of moth. Huh. There's a deer fly. Look, I squashed them. Ugh. They're just horrible. Anyways, we got a little bit of a problem here. Dylan and I went for a little boot around. He wanted to hear what the machine sounded like. I'm like, okay, let's go for a little ride. And so we went for a little ride and something went astray. Nothing to do with the exhaust system, but we'll have to have a look here. It's a good thing I need to tear this thing kind of down to have a look and put that controller card in. So anyways, let's see what's going on here. All right, so what is going on here? I don't know, a little bit of a fuel leak. Don't really want to turn it on for too long, but I don't know if that's exactly going to get you in the right spot, but just turn the key on here. Oh boy, I don't know if you can see that. A little bit of a high pressure fuel leak there. That's not too good. So I don't know what's going on there, but I'm not sure. So I guess what we'll have to do is disassemble. I wanted to take it all apart anyways and get the tank off, and that's while the red cover, the toolbox thing here, has to come off. Get you down a little bit higher up here, sorry. Oh goodness. Okay, so we'll need some tools, and get in the box here, take this front box off, it's not usually too bad. There's some screws here. Like a small Torx, and really long threads, if you know what I mean. So they don't take much to kind of come out of the plastic. Need, I think it's a half inch. For the box here. Get you in a little bit closer here. Okay, so let me grab a half inch. Where the heck will my half inch go? That'll work. 13 mil is pretty close to half inch, roughly. So yeah, when I was over the other day to the dealer getting getting the parts for the exhaust donuts for this thing. I looked at a couple of these new machines. They don't even have these boxes on the front. I'm like, this is so convenient to have another spot to put some bottles of water or whatever have you, you know. I'm like, why would they not put that back in? So basically it's just like a top solid mounted rack that you can tie stuff still to, but I don't know, this was sort of kind of one of the selling features for me when I originally got this thing. It's got all these really cool racks or cool boxes on it, you know. And like, it's pretty freaking handy, I thought. Okay, I don't think it's gonna fall forward on me. No. So, big disassembly here. Her up a little bit. See into the radiator and stuff. Check your levels. She's up good. Well, that system's working good, I guess. Now. That come off. So we have to get this piece off, which looks like it's all mostly Lucius right now. That side plate come off. What do we need back there? Okay. Stuff right this second. I'm trying to find tools. The right tools I need. Okay, so we got to get this big red plastic piece off here now. And I know there's some of those quick clippy things down in there. Good to the last drop of wet. Oh, nothing's really super tight on this thing. Okay, now these things are sometimes a little tricky to get out, but I do have a kind of a sort of special tool here where I put it. Okay, so down in here we got these little things, so you gotta kind of fish out the top piece first. Oh, come on, Ellie. Okay, so that one's out. Another little guy down here. Well, that'll come up better. Okay, so that one's loose. couple more on this side. Do, 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 do.
Nine times out of ten, they don't come out. With them attached, so. That's not too bad, though. That one did. Okay, so that's good. Those are all out.
Resume. I just have to raffle this thing off of here now. Fuel cap will have to come off.
Gotta kind of pinch itself around the steering column, which is kind of different. That piece is off. Now she's getting a little more naked. Put that fuel cap back on, I think, now. Okay. Looks like the intake here for the belt area, the belt ventilation has to come off because it's kind of wrapped around the tank here. A little kind of weirdish. So, how does that come off now? Yeah, see how it's actually quite neatly wrapped all the way around and in. So there's a small little clamp, just, I don't know if you'll be able to see it, it's just underneath the cowling thing here. Get to it. Loose, but it's just in a weird spot. Okay, that should be lots. Okay, that ducting's off. Now, what do we got here? Foamy thing can come off. And what next? Looks like there's plastic mounts on. There's a piece here that's sort of pinching the tank, so that looks like it needs to come off. Should probably actually take the battery off while I'm doing this. That piece is off. Pull that battery terminal off here. Maybe. Okay. The other side here we gotta get off. Oh, we should be able to see what's maybe going on here now too with the fuel. Kind of looks to me, how the heck would that have done that? let's just pull this off. It looks like this is going to be in the way of getting that tank out of there. Looks to me like the somehow the main fuel line unclipped itself. How the heck would it have done that?
I mean, I was in there kind of maneuvering and pulling stuff, but I wasn't actually like right in there. That's the main fuel line there. There's the electronics for there.
Yeah, that's not even clipped on. How the heck would that have come off? Well, that's weird. Huh. Okay, well, I guess it's off now. We'll have to double make sure we check that when we,
when we put her back together. So now this is a little vent line here. It goes up inside the thing. Oh, really, I gotta take this apart too? Oh, wee. I gotta put my little screwdriver down.
This, I think I've had this out before and there's a couple little valve thingies up in here. Then a little valve thingy that's probably attached to or something weird. Okay. So that should just flop it away. Going to just put in these bolts, these little screws back, so remember where everything is. Okay, so yes, up in here. Ooh, what the heck happened there? Sorry. Forgot you were zoomed in. So up in here. So we got this console thing off. So up in here, where's this thing going? Up there, up to here. Okay. So that should be clear and free now. Sorry for the zoom there. I know we zoomed in on that little fitting and I just totally forgot to unzoom it. Okay, tank should be able to come out now. I don't know why that thing was off. You know what, I'm just going to try to re-clip it on here and see if it's alright or if there's something wrong or... Okay, so that's opened. This thing should. I don't know if you can't probably see. There. I don't know how that would have come off. That is weird because that thing's buried. Feels better there now, but somehow it unclipped itself past. And it was kind of sitting like with that little barb thing on the front, so don't ask me. Stranger things have happened. That's a strange thing. Okay, so just to give you a little more insight on that, that thing was sitting kind of like that, or not like that, sorry, it was kind of like, this thing was clipped down, but it was kind of, you know, where it was like ready to pop off. Maybe it's been like that since factory. I don't know. So that should clip on and then snap shut. And that's
definitely on now. Is that a total fluke that I've ran it for like 10 years and it's never come off? Wow, I've been out to a lot of fairly remote places too, and you know, I wouldn't have the tools to get in there to do that, so that would have really kind of sucked. Okay, I think we almost got her down to where we need to get into things here. So we'll try to get this. I think I can get it past this piece. It doesn't start peeing all over me here. Not too bad. Oh, a little more fuel in there than I thought too. Okay, I think we're in. Well, there's the other side of the fuel line here. So this one on the tank goes around, comes out of the into the injector rail here, fuel injector rail. So everything's looking pretty good. I kind of don't think it's right at the injector here where I've got to install those fuel controller. Yeah, I think it's actually way back here, because those plugs don't look right up here on the injectors. I'm pretty sure on the motorcycle, it was right at the injector. This one looks like it comes down here, comes up here. Yeah, that's it there. That's gotta be it. Very interesting. Okay, how the heck are we gonna get in there? I need some more light, hang on. Okay, it's not a very good shot for you guys, but I think it's the piece right in here I need to get to. For some reason they've got it zip tied back around on itself. It's kind of dirty too. I might just grab an airline here and just give it a little blast. All right, I guess they must have zip tied that, so no chance of it actually trying to get pulled apart. So I'm just gonna clip that zip tie off. I've got some more here that I can redo with. Okay, so I'm pretty sure that's where I gotta get to. That's about right there. The controller card there. I just got to read this for a second here. I don't think it matters which one goes to what, but I better just read this. No, it doesn't say anything about where it should go, so that's okay then. Now we got to find a little ground somewhere too, little ground screw. Shouldn't be too hard to find something. And somewhere to mount this thing after. I don't know what to say, boy. Maybe you better give me a minute and I'll get this thing mounted somewhere, because right now I'm not too sure which way to go there. I got so much of it apart here, I don't know where the best way is to go with stuff here. So yeah, give me a sec here, I'll get this figured out. Okay, well I know I got that little panel that comes off right in and about here somewhere. You can get to the fuses and check your fluid. Is that right, or is it up here? It's up in here, I think. So I think I might put it into there somewhere. I just have to figure that out when I get her going back together here. Hopefully I can get that part figured out then. So but anyways, all we have to do here is it's pretty simple. I've actually got the other sides over here for the other cylinder. I'll do this one first here though. Okay, so this is the original plug here, nice and clean, nice and shiny clean still. So
And that gets plugged on. There. The other one is right here. So we need to plug back in the original other side here. Where did he go now? He fell down on me. Come on, you crap head. So that one could get plugged into a wire. Okay. Now these two have to go to this side one. I like how they're putting all these nice automotive airtight, watertight plugs on things now. On to that one. Okay. Well, that worked out pretty good. And we got this part here where I'm going to have to figure out where to put her after, but we got to find a little ground screw somewhere here. I think I can get one down on this frame down here. There's a little screw. I know you can't quite see her there, but it's down. Okay, so I'll get that screw on. Down on the side here. Should be alright. Oh, that's not the right size. Got a freaking nut behind it. Okay, well that's not gonna work. It's probably almost long enough we could get right back to the battery, but I don't know if I want to go that far with it. Oh, for corn flakes. There's nothing else around here anywhere I can get one. They all got nuts on them. That's stupid. Well, sort of stupid. Okay, I'll have to try to find another spot here. Just give me another second. Okay, so I got this thing grounded just to the mounts on the fuse block here. I think that should be fine. It's going right into the frame, so that'll just have to sit there a minute, I guess. So I want to check these plugs as well. I don't know exactly where I'm going to get you guys. I'm going to get you straggled into there somewhere, maybe. And there's one right here. Now, I have no idea size I'm going to need for these, but I've got this 5/8. I gave it all kind of a little brake cleaner job, and holy shnikes, that's the one. Brake cleaner job, cleaned some of the grime off, and hopefully this is a long enough dewy here, and they just come out beautiful, nice. Not too bad. Hopefully it's not too bad looking. Now, got it all apart. Should have got new plugs. Forgot. Totally forgot. But it looks kind of like they do need some.
Ooh, wow. You know what? For not being ever changed or looked at, not too nice sort of looking on there. And there, RC7YC3 maybe, champion. Ooh, but I'll tell you, for that not looking too bad, that's looking pretty darn good. I don't think I mind that too much. There's no carboning on the inner electrode or really on the other or anything. It's just a little bit discolored. So you know what, I will check the other side. I probably will order another set. But everybody says, oh, champion stuff's just garbage. Well, you know what? That's ran for 10 years. Now, it doesn't have that many kilometers on it. You're not going to focus, are you? There, RC7YC3. They're actually looking pretty darn good. So, I might just leave her disassembled. I'll get a new set anyways and throw them in. But, wow, I'm surprised. That's not too bad. Okay, looking down as much as I can see through that little tiny hole. I think the inspection camera would fit, but I'm not going to stuff her in there. I can see in there it looks just about as nice as that plug. So that's good. She's been running, I guess I need that light. She's been running really good. Come on. There. She's been running pretty good, so I will just temporarily put these back in. I have to go out today to the auto parts store, and I presume they would have those. I don't know. If I have to order them online, I have to order them online, I guess. So I will just put that back together for now, and we will pull the other side, see how it's looking. Hopefully it's identical. A little bit more stuff covering you guys here, so I can't really do a whole lot about her. Oh goodness. I don't know what to grab you on them things. I don't want to rip it. There, we're good. Okay, just before I pull that off and any contamination. Where'd it go? See the contamination come out of there? That stuff would have fallen into the cylinder. Probably would have been alright, but still not good on it. I might as well also squirt a bunch of stuff up. Should have been bad. Oh, I need a little longer extension. I think I got it. I do have longer extensions. Okay, I'm gonna grab a longer extension. Okay. Add a piece to her. Makes life a lot easier. Okay. Hopefully this one is pretty much just as good. Pretty much. It's not too bad. The center electrode looking pretty good. Had some goop on her the top from before, so I'll probably redo that. I will just leave that in. That's another Champion RC7YC3. I might get him to cross it over to maybe an NGK plug. I like them a little better, even though Champion, I don't know, seemed good there. Leave that like that. Okay, so I guess I've got to kind of wait until I get plugs. I can't really put anything back together yet because I have to start with the fuel tank, which of course goes, you know, right there. I guess because I've got the fuel injection system power disconnected, it will not even turn on, like click on. So like right now I've got it all disconnected. So if I just touch the battery here, nothing, right? So that system needs to be hooked on to, I wanted to see if I could power up that card. But I guess because of the thing on the fuel tank, you have to plug the electronics back into here. It knows there's a problem, so it's not turning on. So I will have to get plugs, put that back together. I don't exactly know if I'll get to finish it today. I also have another funeral to dig today, of course.
never-ending bounds of funerals.
And yeah, we'll have to maybe try to finish this up tomorrow or something. I'm waiting for the funeral to come in, but yes, so right now I think I am a little bit stuck. I can't do much until I get plugs, but after that I can, you know,
fire it back together. But you never know, we might get to that today
and figure out where we're gonna route this card thing.
I still don't exactly know where until I kind of get the plastics back to it. Nice if it would kind of come through and just kind of come out right in front here, which it might. Oh. Whew. Yeah, that might work there. But the plastic, I don't think will go down on it unless I run it through where the other ones are going through here, maybe. Of course, you guys probably can't see nothing, can ya?
Sorry.
So yeah, this might run up through here. And kind of underneath where some of the other QBs are running. See, I just gotta keep it clear for when this thing clumps and snaps back down on it. That's the only downfall, that we'll maybe have to go there or something, or I don't know. If I like that or not, I should maybe run it up through underneath. I have to unhook everything again, though. I don't think the card itself will fit down through that. Darn it. I can kind of hang down, but I think maybe down in here somewhere would be the best sort of area. Right there, maybe. I don't know. I don't really like it hanging like that, but it's got a sticky pad thing, so I could attach it to the side of the thing here somehow. Whenever I get that figured out. Actually, let's just see if this will fit back on here now. Well, I got the screws into it, but I think that'll work. Then I'll, you know, if I have to, I can sticky pad taper down kind of thing. Because it does have those provisions. Now I gotta put another clip back on there. I guess really why one had and one didn't, but there, almost factory. You mostly hardly wouldn't even know. Down there. The wires for the winch are kind of large. It's probably more negative cable light than I need. Those are the winch. Winch wires going to the front winch there to power that. And I think that should mostly fit there. Okay, well, we gotta get some parts. And we might actually have a couple of vehicles leaving our house today, so we gotta maybe do that soon. All right, we got some new plugs. We cross-referenced them over to a BKR7E NGK, and I just gapped them to 36 thou, which is required for this machine apparently. So that one's for that side, and we got another one in my pocket for this side. I got some dielectric grease here to put on the caps, but first I need to clean the caps a little bit. Let's put you back on the tripod here. Ooh, then heat bugs are going today. That's what that buzz noise is. Okay, so we're going to just take a little bit of compressed air
And if I can get that boot turned around, hopefully. Where'd he go? Here. That turn around. Spray some stuff into it. Try to clean out the crub from before. So the first plug we'll put in, and I'll try to dab some dielectric on top after. Good. First time she's had new plugs, it'll run like brand new. Actually, it wasn't running bad before, so. Okay, I must get my ratchet over here. I'll try to get this thing back together today. I probably won't film the actual reassembly. That's good. Some dielectric on there, so when we punch her on, she's good. Yeah, the reassembly is not as cool and as exciting as the assembly. Or disassembly, sorry. They say, you know, construction kind of sucks, but the ripping apart's awesome. Okay, so we'll just plunk that back on, snap her down. Let's head her to the other side. Okay, gotta take this old one out first again. Let's put them back in so no crap would get down in there, you know. So there's out control. Should have cleaned the plug first. Or cleaned the boot first, sorry. Oh goodness. Goodness sneaks. Okay. Crap. And our new plug. New plug gap to 36 thou. Oh man, I got both of them started. Just bang. That's pretty sweet. Good, don't over tighten. A little dab of dielectric on the top if I can get down there. Good. I swear this dielectric grease is like silicone without the silicone properties, if you know what I mean. This now. Just look inside. It still looks like it's there. Oh, what the heck's going on here? Well, huh. Why is it?
doing that, I wonder. Looks like I gotta shove her down like wicked super hard or something on top of it for it to click on. I wonder if I kind of pulled that out a little bit maybe when I was pulling the boot off. I wasn't kind of expecting that. The other one's on good. This one's not so good. I don't think I can even get that really off of there. Yeah, I think that's actually gonna have to try to work at that. I can see a line on here where it was sitting. So somehow this thing has pulled itself out. That's not too good. I'm not gonna do with that. Well, give me a second and I will figure this out. Okay, so I think what's happened, I got the whole thing off right now. Comes off pretty easy. I think what happened was when I pulled that plug off, hang on, I grabbed her by here, but it stayed attached to the plug and it actually pulled it out. So this coupler thing is actually way up in here. It should be way down here more. So I gotta try to figure out how to get that back down. I might have to lube her all up in there and try to get this wire to move again, because I don't know, I'm gonna have to work at that one. Okay, well, we got her fixed. I just had to get a pair of needle nose in there and pulling the boot, pushed on the wire. Lots of fun. Got her rerouted, plugged back in. Juicer. It just plugs in over here. I guess this is like a ignition coil box or something. I re-greased that, put her back on. The other one I didn't touch, so I'm just gonna leave her. So yeah, that's all good. Just gonna double check all my connections here on everything. Things on and tight. These you don't grease because they have like the watertight seal in them. So should be all good though. Looks all good. I think that is good. Okay. So I'm not gonna probably film the reassembly part of it here, just because, you know, like I was saying, it's probably more interesting for you guys to see the, you know, tear down than it is to rebuild kind of thing. So yeah, I'll probably just go ahead and do her and fire it up when we're done. Okay, here I go. All right, pretty much back together, just the side panel and the seat, but I want to double make sure. We got no leaking issues. Remember before it was like, let's see, just turn it on. No squirting. Well, that's good. I'm going out of that. That was kind of crappy. I don't know why, what happened there. But anyways, we had to take her apart anyways. So that was kind of good timing, I guess. So everything's still on good. Okay, let's crank her. Now this thing, I was expecting to see some lights come on, which there's nothing. Let's crank her here. Oh, couple out of gear. There we go. Well, she fired right up. That's actually running a bit lower too. That is running different. Listen to it. Sounds nice. I didn't think that fuel thing would do that. It's definitely running lower. Oh, I like her. Sounds a little better now. Oh. The thing is, the camera just won't capture that for you.
found Peppy. Might have to go for a ride after. Oh wow, just sit here and listen to this run for a minute. Very bassy. Think that control card would do that, but to me it sounds a whole lot different. It sounds like it's running a bit lower too, like lower RPM at idle, which is kind of sweet. I don't kind of sort of mind that so much, so I'll have to take it for a little ride, but right now I do need to get back to work and set up a grave for tomorrow. So I guess in my front box I will replace tire patch kit, little tube, blower up thing, and a couple extra pulling straps. Ugh. Just in case, because the odd time you need to extend your winch, or whatever have you. There we go, let's hear it again, ready? Oops. I must have screwed up the first one. Let's try it again. That's better. Wow. That's giving her about 3,000 more horse right there, I think. Super awesome. Sweet. All right, well, I just went for a little boot on her. I had to... I had to do a little bit of chainsawing in that hole. It was near an old tree roots all over the place, of course. So a little bit of chainsawing and then a little wee bit of pruning after to get some of the small hairy ones, you know, little hairy things. So everybody wants to get buried near a tree. It's the worst place you could go, honestly. Everybody's like, oh, have you got anything near any tree? No, I don't. Trees are nice, yeah, okay. They make oxygen for us, fine. When the trees die, burn them in your fireplace, keep you warm, fine. Don't ever get buried near a tree because it's a freaking nightmare for people that have to do it for you. For instance, me. Especially when it's really close to a tree, it really sucks. Pretty much, the machine's good at tearing stuff off, you know, but some stuff doesn't work. You have to get in there and saw it and blah blah blah, and you know, holy cow, sometimes you end up killing a tree doing that, right? Because you have to cut so much of the branches or the roots off. So anyways, it's all good to go, ready to rock for tomorrow. I think we're good. But I kind of totally ran myself out of time for today, so no cars gone. As my cousin said, he was coming today to get cars, never showed up, so I don't know what's going on there. But I've run myself out of time, as in time to render, upload, process for you guys for around 10:30 tonight-ish. So, got to get rocking. So, yeah. That's all I can say is, yeah. So, but she ran good. I put that screen in. I thought I might have taken a little bit of that sort of snappy-ish sound out of it. Still don't like that. Kind of hardly see it in there now, but I did install that screen. There you go. So, but it's still pretty loud. I don't know, I guess it's the way she's going to be until it maybe gets wore in a bit, broken a bit. She's still smoldering a little bit in there, I guess. But seemed to run good, and just that little snappy, once you get it to a certain RPM, it kind of goes levels off, and it's not bad, but that one little spot there's a little snappy, and I'm not super crazy on that. So, but yeah, anyway, she was good. Three runs good. Didn't fart, bang, snap, or bang or anything where it shouldn't have, you know. It was running nice and smooth and stuff. So get one more fire up here for you.
Oh,
tricked you. Sound like if I put that great big exhaust pipe on it. Let's try a little experiment. Shows you how much water we got last night, how much rain, and that's actually evaporated a little bit. You can see the, it was sitting there where it rested a little bit. Well, that's actually warm. Sitting out here in the sun, it's gotten warm. Oh, hey, I've got an idea. Someday swimming pool, redneck swimming pool. Come on, it'll work. If you want to dump it out, just tilt it up. She goes. It'll probably hold a pretty much a, you know, throw a tarp in it. Throw a tarp in it, start filling her, leave her in the sun. She'd be nice and warm by lunch. I think it would be anyways. Sweet. Well, I got to get that dumped out of there somehow. So, I need to find a key. I don't have my hydraulic lines hooked up, but that would be an easy way out. But I think the water will just kind of come out when we go around the corner here. Whoop. She's draining. Hey, you know what? I think that tarp idea, fill it up with water, I think that would work. I would have, of course, washed the inside out first, maybe a little bit. But hey, you know what? Cheap redneck pool. The kids would love it. You have to wash some dirt out, though, maybe. But, yeah, you know what? not a too huge of a tarp would probably do, or... I don't know, that's too... Maybe not quite 2 foot by 4 feet, so 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, give her 10 by 8, and 10, 11, 12, so a 10 by 14 tarp would probably do her. I don't know if they come that size, but I think I got some in here. This is a total different job for a different day, but yeah, I've got one. One tarp somewhere here. Yeah. Tarp. That might actually work. Wow. Aw, crap. I went and got innovative. A little bit. Redneck swimming pool. There we go. There's a bit of crap coming out of the pipe, though, I guess. A little bit of rusty stuff. Look at it all laying down here. There's a metal pipes that run from like the back of the church, cross, turn and come up into here. You can see it right there. That's where I'm feeding at us. So I don't run much water here, but I guess I'm running her so fast, she's breaking off some little chunks of stuff. So that's not too good. But I don't know if I want to put too much more in it right now. Just because I got to get it up to the house. See if the kids want to go swimming. Crazy. Redneck totally. I know. Okay, I've driven a lot of dirt. Dirt tends to kind of stay where you leave it. This may not. I might have to fill her up a bit up at the house when we get up there. I don't know if she's going to stay in there or not. I gotta also go up a bit of hill too, so it's probably gonna, I got her actually tilted a bit backwards to level her off a bit there. Let's see if we can get this up here. Usually either, right? It stays where you put her. Oh, don't come in now, people. Holy crap, what a bad time to come in the gate. It's crazy. Anyways, I gotta try to get up. Maybe I'll try to back her in or something here. It's a little bit of an incline back here, so I don't know how well this is gonna work. But as I slow down slowly, don't do that tarp. Don't want to get the water under the tarp. Also put her down onto the jack, I think maybe what I'll probably do, if they actually get in it, they probably won't get in it, but you never know. You never know. Okay. I'll go out and get him. Okay, come see your brand new swimming pool. Hello? Come see your pool. Hello?
Oh my gosh.
Are you going swimming? You gonna go swimming? It's a little cool, but it'll warm up in the sun. What do you think? And look, you got a shallow end and a deep end. And then I can do this. Then you have a deep end down there. Look at that, eh? Sweet. Yeah. And if you want a wave pool, look, a wave pool. Oh, sweet. I want to get in there. That's awesome. Any wave pool. Ah! That's awesome. Oh, that is so cool. You even got a wave pool in it. I didn't even think of that. Good idea. And you even got wet. Oh, that is cool. Maybe she'll warm up a bit in the sun and you can go swimming. It's a little cool right now. Ah! Sweet, eh? What do you think?
Cool.
Cool, cold, sweet, cool. Neat, eh? Let her warm up a bit. All right, well, that's about it for today. I don't know if we'll probably won't film swimming. That's kind of weird, you know? But anyways, if they go swimming, they probably won't go swimming, but who knows? But anyways, my cousin did text me and he said he'll be here around 6, which it's 5:07 now. I don't know if I can include that today or not, him taking those away. I'm almost out of battery here anyways, so I might just do it on my iPhone or something, and we'll go from there. So I'll put it on another video someday. So, but anyways, thanks again for watching. We'll catch you later, and let you know how the pool goes. If they get in, I don't know if they will or not, but anyways, have a good night. Thanks for watching, if you can see me, and have a good night, and we'll catch you later. Oh, we got dual trucks here. Holy cow, I don't know if I can film all that. Sweet. Rid of the garbage. I don't even know if I can get that guy. He's probably gonna get her hooked up and gone before this is done. Ooh, I think I might go the other side. The sun's in my face. Better run, Chip Chip. She's in neutral. The second heap.
Goodbye, heap.
Goodbye, heap. Somewhat semi.
Well, that one might make it, you know. I don't know. That tire looks like it's getting flatter as they go.
Yeah, I don't know. He'll be alright. It's not going that far. I'm sure he's got a pumper if he needs a pumper. The old microwave's in there too still. The one that we crushed. Oh, that kind of feels much better, you know that? Get rid of some garbage. Get rid of some garbage. Snowplow, that wasn't me. Come on, light change so we can get rid of the garbage. That car actually probably could have been fixed. Oh, he's got his lights on the wrong side. Whoops. He'll never see that. I don't even think I could shout that far away. It's a lot further than it looks. Nope. I guess we got lights on the truck too. A little confusing, but might have been a newer guy he had there. I don't know. He couldn't kind of figure a few things out on that truck. And there goes the heap. And the Buick heap. Gone. Down the road with the rest of the junk.